That was exhausting.
Up there. See it?
Boy.
Sir. Another marker.
Come on.
brother.
Seems like the right thing to do. Mimir, why did the Dwarf King want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvegra Heaker. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so. Okay, here we go.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess. Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Here, boy. Another one.
Stargather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
Looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.
sound almost like... Hellwalker! Hey, look at this. Blood trail.
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signir. Interesting. I may want to write that down. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't... Doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
I wonder what this place looked like in better times.
Conan'sGard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said, and the Dwarf King lost.
Atreus, follow me.
Yes, sir.
You found the legendary materials? Incredible.
Oh, this is so exciting. Meet me back at the temple and we'll get started right away.
Or, never mind then.
I didn't think we'd see you out here, since you and Brock got back together. Everything okay?
Oh.
Boy.
Right behind you. Hang on. Mimir, you called Brock and Sindri the Holdra brothers?
Aye.
But they're dwarves, aren't they?
Aye.
And Holdra are sprites of the forest.
Aye.
Beautiful, seductive sprites of the forest.
So why would you call Brock and Sindri the Holdra brothers?
Oh, well, I now realize this would be a wholly inappropriate story for young and innocent ears.
Whatever.
You boys look right beaming.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so... so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
What'll it be? Sorry you wasted my time.